the long deserted road in front of us. Just that car wasn't there.
You filming?
No.
No filming.
No filming, it's a car. Don't
turn
film
camera
me.
Off, no.
Turn camera off. Don't film the Mona Lisa. No, no, stop, stop.
You not come back from this.
Yes.
You two don't behave, I'm gonna pull over.
Well, I'm gonna pull over in a minute anyways.
Why?
I'm sick of you guys back there. No, there's a really nice scenic view coming up.
Oh, okay.
Looking in my rear view mirror until it...
In other words, we're going to see something different than what we're looking at right now within a few minutes.
Did you ever see the Clint Eastwood movie, Every Which Way But Loose?
No, but I know.
At the very end of the movie, Clint Eastwood, Sandra Locke, and the orangutan drive away, and it's on this road.
Oh. All right.
See, I'll have to get the movie now.
Yeah, we'll have to. Is there like a little marker somewhere that...
Well, no, the Valley of Fire, they filmed Star Trek there. They filmed a whole car commercials, movies.
It's very famous.
You've now said the key word.
Yes.
Yeah,
see,
Star
I knew
Trek.
this was actually why Billy wanted me to see it. Because the original series
You didn't know Star Trek was filmed in the Valley of Fire?
No.
The outdoor ones there where Kirk fought the big monster?
No, but I do know, what's that one? Nemesis.
Yes.
There's a whole scene in the desert with a dune buggy that the car drives at the beginning of that movie.
Okay.
And I wonder if that's this desert.
I don't know.
Usually when they want a desert location, Valley of Fire is one of the more popular places.
And in the movie, though, there is absolutely no green. It's all cracked.
Valley of Fire is on the other side of this ridge.
Whoa. Okay. Wow. Here, let me close this door. Wow, so we are out there. Smells fresh, eh?
So
no
fresh.
Cigarette smoke out here.
Well, welcome to the Mojave Desert.
Wow, look at, we stopped in the middle of nowhere,
so
ladies and gentlemen. What are those little rocks are piled up? There's something there. Look at that.
It just goes on and on and on.
And it goes on and on and on. Da 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 da. Area 54 is somewhere out there. Area 51. Studio 54. Studio 54 and Area 51.
Area 54, that's where the aliens go.
Wow, look at how what's going on here? Look how adorable that is.
Do you want Gary?
Oh, yeah, of course he does. Are you nuts?
No, he didn't ask for you.
get one.
Sure.
Go, you get in there first. We'll do multiples.
Gary, you want to move a little bit either in the picture or right?
Are we?
And... Nice. Okay, let's all do the other side,
yeah,
too.
Okay,
guys are funny.
There's a car coming?
Helicopter.
A helicopter. They're coming to chase us off the area. They're coming to chase us out of Area 51. Did you? I'm sorry, George. Did you want a series?
I'll tell you what. The best one is when you're all doing this.
Well, that's the only two pictures we did.
Okay, so
there were two of them.
You should put your cameras in the trunk, right?
No, I'm keeping mine. Area 51 helicopter coming to get us. Wherever it is, I can't see it.
It's good because the sound of the real helicopter isn't good enough. You've got to do your own.
I hear you, girl.
Sound.
Oh, here, let me move my basket. Valley of Fire, my friends.
Something, eh?
You know what I love? The air is crisp and fresh.
It's not that dry, brutal, exhaust concrete thing that is going on in Vegas. That's killing me, that I find.
Oh yeah, Gerard too.
Between the air conditioning and the exhaust winds, my eyes dry right out. It's quite something.
So here's Las Vegas. We drove along the, there's a map here, 15 through the Mopa River Indian Reservation. We got up here, we started coming down, or we came in here probably. And there's the Valley of Fire right there. It's where we are. There's Lake Mead.
Way. That looks like it's been blown or sculpted. I said it looks like it's been blown or sculpted.
Have you seen anything like it before?
Never in my life, I have to say. Actually, no, when I was in Utah and also in Utah, I would say, yeah. Utah.
Oh, I'm glad to see.
Yeah, specifically like that. That's right. Very unique. But I've seen
it is.
That formation. So home on
the range, where the deer and the antelope play. Where seldom is heard.
They're ready.
All right, you gotta do what they do. Can you imagine if they took off and left us here? Oh, home on the range. We're the
what? We're up for a little hike. It's kind of pleasant. When we get to White Domes, there's a place where they filmed a movie, a western in the 1960s.
Right.
And it's about a mile hike round trip, and it's how do you feel, Ryan? I mean, you got your jaw open.
A mile? Walking a mile? You want us to walk a mile out into here?
No. And there's this one place. Oh, it's so cool.
Is your dad going to walk it too?
No, he stays with the car.
We were just discussing the beauty of nature and the finding how mathematics and number logic is found in nature, and we have learned.
Okay, so and then because it's stunning up there, right?
The golden mean. If you do nothing in your life, learn about the golden mean.
Okay, thank you. I like
saying
that.
Saying it again.
I was just joking.
I know you.
I turned the camera quickly just
as
a joke.
I was laughing at
you. Good. Wow. Well, but I do find it intriguing that you would come all this way. Like, it is pretty neat. It is a neat day trip. It's true, actually. It is.
It's part of the desert.
Experience,
beauty of
eh?
The desert.
Wow. Amazing.
Yeah. Everyone, when you say the desert, everyone pictures, you know, that flat. And in fact, there's an infinite.
See, there's see the rock over there? It's from the Roadrunner. Coyote.
Oh, did they film that movie cartoon here?
Yeah, they filmed that cartoon.
Oh my god! That is so cool.
Yeah. Bugs Bunny's based on
there's
the Valley
There's gotta
Fire.
Be an Acme sign somewhere. We will find it. Okay, yeah, you know what? We can recreate our own movie magic out here. Oh my god, sand! Another surprise. Look at that, wow. It's been 2.5 hours.
This is a mine sand. A sand mine.
Oh. Wow. The car broke down.
Yeah, you know what? I can't do this.
I know, but just do a bit with us.
No, I'm totally dizzy.
Oh, Pookie movie.
For sure, yeah. No, I gotta.
Alright.
So. I just want to show you on the film. The car is there. This is how far Diane got.
Yeah, no, what I do.
No, it's good. You tried it, girl. We'll be back soon. Don't you worry.
You gotta keep going?
Yeah, of course. A little bit. No, good 10 minutes. But I want to get past this. I want to get over the hoop here. Of course. I want to reenact some of the classic moments from movie and television.
This is so wild.
You know what's great is the silence. I have not heard dead silence like that in years.
Yeah, with the exception of the car behind me?
Yeah.
It's nothing.
It's fabulous.
No sound at all.
The Valley of Fire, way out in the Nevada desert. We did see a lizard, but no other life other than the plant life. It's been 2.5 hours we've been walking, starting to get
so
tired.
There's
remains of movie sets somewhere out here, but probably not right away. Yeah. Oh, getting dizzy. Can't continue. Blurriness getting blurred. Starting to feel the heat. Okay, I'm back. I was just trying my hand at acting. Okay. Yeah, absolutely no No water to be heard of. Oh, here we are. Now we're really seeing the view we came for.
Yeah, so.
Yeah. You don't see, you know what? I'm gonna laugh. You'll hear the. We're in the desert shooting the cover of Nature Water.
Nature Boy.
Nature
Boy. Yeah, I got one without the sunglasses.
Oh, one without the sunglasses. There we go. Hey, good picture. There we go. This is the cover of Sports Illustrated. All right, you've got a Speedo under there. Stripped down.
Oh, God, you're just wrong.
I'm William Shatner. We're in the Valley of Fire in Nevada, shooting Star Trek VII, and you won't believe what you're gonna see.
First of all, you've got to understand this is not planet Earth. This is an alien world in another part of this galaxy.
The mystery of this land is where did all the colors and the rock formations come from.
It's one of the wonders of the world. I think there's a petrified forest somewhere near here. Lake Mead, over there, the Hoover Dam. It's one of the wonders of the world. We're lucky in a way to be here.
This was once a sea. So we're on the seabed of an ancient sea. What was here? Jurassic Park.
It's in a magnificent place. It really is. I've never been to anywhere quite like this. Reminds me a bit of maybe, has overtones of Death Valley or Monument Valley, perhaps, and maybe places in Utah, you know.
The rock formations are continuously interesting. The sun forms different shadows every moment as it goes across the sky, and the cinematographer is watching and looking with real envy because we have to do the day's work. And yet the light gets better as the sun fades. The best light is just before the sun goes below the horizon, but you can't get many shots in that period of time.
Well, we were looking for a place. We were looking for a place that didn't look like any other place on Earth. And the Valley of Fire has some marvelous topography and almost volcanic look. The reddishness of the rocks is why they call it the Valley of Fire.
After a lot of location scouting, David Carson selected a very remote location, and we had to build it and shoot it in the middle of the summer. And it was just appallingly hot. It was 105, 110 degrees every day.
And our difficulty with this particularly beautiful park is that we had to find a place that was close to the road for all our vehicles. And so when we first scouted the location, we went and we looked at a hill down there. And we stood on top of it and went, but this isn't the highest part around here. Let's go up there.
There were not very many other choices. And I think it was the location that sparked everybody's imagination, even before we went there, when we just saw the pictures of it.
We looked for a place which didn't look like Earth, and which and where we could put Sauron very close to the sky, which looked like the highest place around.
The other choice might have been Trona Peaks, but we'd used Trona Peaks in Star Trek V, and it didn't have the, it didn't have that sense of volcanic coloring that the Valley of Fire has.
Everywhere you look, it's a fantastic, spectacular 360 degrees where you cannot see any civilization at all. It has the most wonderful, unearthly quality.
The whole place has a feeling of somewhere where human beings have no right to be. It's entirely alien, and I mean no pun by that, to creatures like us.
The vista is enormous. I mean, the vista is like you're on a planet with no civilization in existence in any direction. That's pretty hard to find, especially in the western part of the United States, close to Los Angeles, anyway.
Incidentally, the only way that you can achieve the summit there is going hand over hand up a rope, and every single member of the cast and crew has done that every time we got up to the summit.
We had people working for us whose only job was climbing up the mountain. It was a good 15-minute hike up the mountain, and there were places where you literally had to hold on to ropes to get up because it was slippery and it was steep. And they had to put all kinds of stanchions for safety purposes. There were two or three guys whose job was solely to bring bottled water up and empty bottles down, because there was nothing up there whatsoever.
Very good, here we go. Okay, recording dialogue, everyone. Everyone settle in, don't move, don't whisper. Here we go. And our artists are set. Roll, please.
Rolling.
Sound speed.
And sticks.
Action.
You don't have to do this, Sauron. I'm sure we can find another way of getting you into this nexus.
I've spent 80 years looking for another way. Believe me, this is the only one.
Cut!
Shake the bridge. And action!
During the course of the filming, the bridge is blown up at one end by Sauron, and Kirk is caught on the edge of the bridge, and the controller that he has to catch slides down this broken span, and of course Kirk catches it at the last moment, is able to decloak, and then Patrick Stewart is able to get to the firing mechanism and change the rocket so that it doesn't go into the planet and create the Nexus phenomenon. So all of that was the second ending that I think added a great deal to the excitement of the ending. Certainly was less cowardly on the part of Sauron to have shot Kirk in the back.
24th century isn't so tough.
Kirk indeed is killed then in a more heroic way, where he is found in the wreckage of the blown up bridge. I personally crawled in and was Kirk's understudy for that sequence, making sure that David Carson, the director, had Kirk's face and body in the right location inside the wreckage. And I climbed out and Bill climbed in. It was a good thing that we did. It was a better ending, and it made a stronger picture.
If we do it, we make a difference.
Oh, yes. We made a difference.